Merciful goddess, mother of the forlorn, who have no place to call their own. Please bear witness to our resolve. Fire for Ariandel. Fire for Ariandel. And the ash to kindle flame.
Hello, Dark Souls fans, and welcome back to Let's Die Horribly in Dark Souls 3 with the Ashes of Ariandel DLC, which is now out. So let's do the thing! Talk to this guy.
You've the same scent as that woman. Then you must be an action one. You must be. You don't know how long I've searched.
What, lying prostrate down there? Okay, I guess that's one way of searching. Seems a little bit tedious, but you do you.
Oh, don't mind me. Didn't mean to fall apart. Now, Ashen One, I have a kindness to ask of you. My lady lives in the cold land of Ariandel. I need you to show her flame. A proper flame that will burn the rot away. If you truly are ash, then it must be fire that you seek.
Sure, why not? Let's do this thing. I mean, that's why I'm here. Let's be honest.
Thank you. They of ash never fail. Just a moment, then. The painting of Ariandel. Well, rotted scrap of it, that is. Go on. Take it. Touch it.
Hey, this again. Well, for those of you who are familiar with Dark Souls 1, this again. Otherwise, yeah, this is a thing that happens. It just happens, yeah.
And then the ashes were too.
Okay, I mean, bonfire warping is a thing, you realize. Oh, admittedly, first I have to find a bonfire.
Have you just arrived? How very unusual. Just how long has it been? Rejoice, my new friend. For this is a true haven of the forlorn, the cold and gentle painted world of Ariandel. Quick, go along. Find one for yourself.
How many painted worlds are there?
A sweetly rotting bed to lie upon. Yes, of course. You're no exception. We've all seen terrible things. But you're safe now. Let it ease your burden. Ariandel will make a fine home for you. So, go on ahead. Find one for yourself. A sweetly...
Yeah, okay, I get it. Yeah, whatever. Rhyme Blue Moss Clump. Okay, so we're dealing with Frostbite. Alright. Let's kill some things. Because that's what we're all here for. Hey, it's a bonfire. Not quite Ariamus, but okay. I wonder if the guy's still there. I just feel like it'd be amusing. Just go back there. Yeah. See what he thinks. Oh, and, well, fair enough. Worth a shot. Back to the actual business, though. Let's actually get to it. Properly. With the whole painted worldy thing. Because this should be cool. So yeah, the painted world of Ariamis was a thing in Dark Souls 1, optional area. Pretty cool. Let's see what the painted world of Ariandel is like. Oops. One should face that. Well, I've beaten the game, so yeah. Let's not worry about this. Let's just do the thing. Let's see, you're... Oh, wow, that's... Getting Dark Souls 2 flashbacks here. Ah! I'm also forgetting how to play a martial character. Alright, that works. In the meantime of me playing this whole Let's Play thing, I've actually been playing with a character that's... For those of you who've been watching my casting of Battlerite, it was kind of based off of Jade from Battlerite. But basically a pure ranged character. And it's very different from how the game works when you have pure pure melee, or mixed melee. I should probably get used to it, actually. Get my bloody thing up. Of course. Shields are a thing. Kicking is also a thing. It's an irrelevant thing, apparently. I will cut you! And then I'll cut you again! And I'll, ow! Alright, fine. We're gonna play that game, huh? Ha! So they didn't repose. But that works anyway! You're dead. That's the important thing. What matters in life is that everybody else is dead. And you two. What do you have? You have a Titanite Shard! How utterly useless to me. Seeing as, what do I have right now? I have, well, maxed out. Except the Bellvine. That's not totally maxed out. Oh, speaking of which, what's my health rate? Oh, crap! Alright then. But yeah, these enemies remind me a lot of... Oh, the... I think it was the pirates in No Man's Wharf in Dark Souls 2. There's just that helmet. There's something about that helmet that's very Dark Souls 2-y. Oh, hey, it's a wolf. How problematic. This is gonna suck. Well, I should say, it's a pack of wolves. And here I am with a crossbow. And the ability to, well, potentially summon... Divine help. Okay, this is not gonna work. There we go, that's better. Okay. Good dog, nice dog. I mean, if they weren't killing me, they'd be actually pretty cute. I'm more of a cat person myself, but... Ow. Ah, shoot. That's better. Sit, stay, play dead. I said play dead. Okay, well, that was a surprise. But not really. One thing, it's like, what is gonna try to kill me next? Trees! Of course. Fire trees. That seems counterproductive. Ow. Huh. Okay, well, how do you like cuts? Ah! Swords are not good tree-cutting implements! I probably should have invested in an axe. I have so many life choices to regret. the heck is that one going? Ah, there it is. Die. Die, tree! Look, I may be using a sword, but I'll still cut you down. Even if it's slow and inefficient and without the proper weight at the end. Man, all these trees. And now wolves. Okay, this is bad. Let's retreat. Since I have wolves to deal with, and not much to deal with them with. Ah! Okay. Good. Get you out of the way. Last thing I want to deal with trees is wolves. Not something I thought I'd be dealing with when I woke up this morning. Was trees and wolves at the same time. Ah, more trees and wolves. These wolves take a little... They take the sweet time. Oops. And another wolf. Are you coming at me? Coming at me, wolf? Hey, what the... The tree sure is. Come on, wolf, pick up the hustle. You call that hustle. I've seen dashes that were more spry than you. Although, admittedly, dashes are actually kind of vicious, but that's not the point. The point is you're a disappointment to your species. Oh, what? Seriously, you're not dead? Another- Oh! Ice this time! That's new. And harder to deal with, actually. Oh wait, no it's not. I just go behind you. And then cut, because that's how things work. Large Titanite Shard. Also, utterly useless. Titanite chunks would be a nice thing to have. Maybe another Titanite slab. Oh my. Hey, we're in Bloodborne now. Oh wait, no, those ticks were in Dark Souls. No, but they're different. These are different. They're more like giant mosquitoes. Hmm. How are we gonna do this? Apparently the easy way. Alright, cool. I'm good with that. Nope, you want a challenge. Alright, one of them wants to die faster. I'm happy to oblige. Ah, seriously? Jeez. Okay. Well, that's the thing. So, at any rate, we have a bunch of mosquitoes, and the mosquitoes don't like to have swords in their faces. Which, admittedly, is reasonable. Very few creatures do well with a sword in their face. Whoops. Well, didn't want to deal with that, but I guess I have to. Man, what is this thing? See, that's the annoying thing, is that these trees are just everywhere, so it's very difficult to tell where they... what's a tree and what's something else. Like, what's just scenery? I mean, that's the point, obviously, but... At least the ice trees are more manageable. Wah! Shoot! Put me down? No, you're not... Great, that... That's just perfect. Well, okay, I guess now they know they have a grab attack. I'm gonna take a different path. We know that's there. Oh, hey, the tree's right here. Oh, what the- Oh! Oh, that's tricky. Oh, that is really tricky. Also spears, what the hell? You call that range- Ah! That's how you fight ranged. Amateur. So, are there crazy trees here? No, there are not. There are simply Dark Souls 2 references. Or strike me as Dark Souls 2 references. Honestly, haven't played the game in a while. I could be thinking other things that aren't accurate. Ooh, poison gem. That's potentially useful. I probably won't use it, but that's a thing that exists. That's actually one of the things about playing a pure ranged character with the other build, is that you can't use infusion. Like, ranged weapons do not benefit from infusion at all. Like, there's nothing. Bows don't benefit, crossbows don't benefit, nothing benefits. So it's actually really kind of tricky. Ah, shoot, I'm getting locked down here. Come on, there we go. I'll have you. Stabby! There we go. Told you I'd have you. Oh. Suppose that makes sense. You have fire, I have stabs. Hey, you said you needed to bring fire to this place. They've got plenty of fire. They're good for fire. I don't know what my job is anymore. Clearly fire isn't really among it. I mean, okay, they don't have much fire, and they've got a lot of ice. Ooh, lore! Stuff to read! Let's read it. Follower boots. Boots worn by the Farron followers. When a warrior of Farron fell of the abyss, the tall, lean followers with their hollowed eyes quietly appeared in groups to hunt them down. Farron and its watchers fell to ruin, but the followers survived as a wandering pack of hollows. Good to know. Can't say I'm entirely surprised. But good to know nonetheless. You did stuff. Oh, what the? Oh, that's the thing that happens twice, is it? Okay. I figured it would already have been gone, but nope, apparently. Oh, right, right, this is Dark Souls 3. Nothing stays permanent in Dark Souls 3. Whenever you die, the entire world resets. Still a different path. Oh, hey, a wolf. Nice try. Oh, actually, that try actually worked. Ambush of what, trees? Oh, yes, actually. Oh, I see, you can tell. There's a little glowing at the bottom. If they're magic tree. And not just a tree that looks like a magic tree. And also wolves. Hi, wolves. Ooh. Bad dodge there. You did not do your friend any favors. There are a lot of you. He dodges. Your dodges keep not doing your friends favors. You keep killing them. I mean, yeah, that wasn't really nice. Bye, wolves. Okay. That's not as terrifying as I thought it would be. And you're another magic tree. Thank you, writing on the ground. Helpful as always, except when you're trolling. Wow. Okay, well, I can kill you, no problem. And you. Problem is more so the hill. It's really hard to see what's going on up down the hill. But I can stab you, because you're using a shield. Bad move. I can't deal with shieldless opponents easily. But shields, love dealing with shields. All right, so at this point, not a whole lot of Ariandel reference, to be quite, ow. Well, you actually speared me. Well done. What the heck is that wolf? Or is that these things make wolf sounds? Ow. Okay, well, oh no, there is a wolf. Never mind. You're done. You're done. And I can rest. Okay, but yeah, this, there's no, like, crow women, there's no, what else was there in Ariamis? Oh yeah, those pus hollows that spewed toxin everywhere when you killed them. Those are a pain. None of those here, come on. Ah, you stupid camera. There we go. Sheesh. Be nice if you locked on. Anyway. Follower javelin. About time I get me one of those. Not that I'm planning to use it, but hey! Let's see. Light spear wielded by the Faron followers. Balanced to allow for throwing. The followers attack in groups, surrounding foes, shielding themselves and thrusting their spears at the foes. On a final command, they hurl their spears at their fallen foe to give the retired warrior an honorable send-off. And the skill is, of course, to hurl a spear! By throwing an illusory spear that assumes a temporary form. That's a thing. Let's throw one. Wait, wrong one. So it's stabby, stabby, big stab. Charging, no, it's not charging stab. Throw! Whee. Well, that was a neat experiment. And this is still proving that, man, that longsword. Really good to have a longsword. These wolves would be far harder if I just used the coiled sword. I don't know if that'd be really possible. Follower gloves, I'm gonna guess that's the same as what we had with the other stuff. Oh no. When a warrior of Faron fell into the abyss, the tall lean followers with their hallowed eyes quietly appeared in groups to hunt them down. And everything else we've already seen. So that's the wolves done, and that's the area above with the Faron watchers done, so it just means trees and mosquitoes, and then we're back on track. Except, of course, more wolves. Whoa! More and bigger. Well, you're dead. Well, I have a chance to deal with you. Ah! Well, okay. This place is getting annoying. Like, really annoying. I'd expect... I don't know. What a... Get away from me. Fine, new stuff. Here we are. Deal with that direwolf later. Deal with the direwolf. I'm in the mood to deal with the direwolf. I'm not in the mood to deal with that thing right now. Not in the mood to deal with you either. I will kill you. I killed you. Just die. Like I said, more of a cat person. Much more of a cat person. Stupid dogs. Well, okay, looks like I have to drop down from there somewhere. Deal with that later! Don't really care, it's probably not that relevant. No, wait, I can deal with that right now. Well, okay, I guess that's kinda nice. Looks like there's really not a whole lot to deal with, honestly. I mean, it did say brief resp- Whoa! Oh. Hmm. It's a bonfire. Well, that's good. That's a better position, I think. Not quite as bullshit as looking for. Actually, that's just... Let's human up again. This is... I like having the health from human form. It's just nice. That extra little bit of HP is always a nice thing to have. Oh, is this another thing where I can cut down? Looks like. I mean, Catacombs of Karth has had that trick. Yeah, thankfully I'm at the level that I want this character to be at, so I don't really worry about souls that much. They kind of matter for stuff like crossbow bolts, but I got crossbow bolts, I think. Yeah, I got crossbow bolts for days. We're good there. I'm assuming you're hostile. Oh, these guys. Oh, the crow bastards. And I forgot about this version of humanoid crows that Dark Souls 3 has, because Dark Souls 1 is a totally different kind of humanoid crow. Not like this at all. Hmm. Oh, you're friendly.
Well, well. You're Lady Yuria's Lord of Hollows. No bell tolls. And yet, you've slipped into the painting. Ah, no matter. If you've lost your way, the words of Lady Frida will guide you. Now, go on inside, show respect, and listen carefully. What's keeping you? Go on, right inside. Show respect, and let Lady Frida speak to you.
And by speak, I assume you mean attempt to kill me, because that's what things do here. It's considered a gentle greeting. Kind and polite. To attempt to murder your foes. Hey! There we go. Catacombs of Karthus all over again. I guess I could kill a bunch of wolves this way, but then I couldn't go back. Oh, okay, good to know. I was wondering, was the ladder on the other side? Did I do this wrong? No, this is definitely the way to go. Alright, what's down here? Is it another mini-boss type thing? Does it lead to another optional area, like with the demon and everything after that point? And the catacombs? And the smoldering lake? Looks like... maybe? This point appears to lead to a quick death. Or something approaching the Great Hall. Oh, this is a very Great Hollow. This is very Great Hollow. Yes, very, very Great Hollow. In all the worst ways. Oh, what the? What the hell? Ugh. How was I even supposed to deal with that stupid thing in a dropping attack anyway? This area is just annoying me from the beginning. Alright, whatever. Let's check that again. Sometimes I wonder why I even bother. Anyway. It did appear to be just that one enemy, but man, how do you... That's supposed to be dropping attack! That's dropping attack, father! That's how you do it. You do a dropping attack and then it works. I'm gonna wait for this whole thing. Might as well kill you lot while I'm at it. Not that I really care, but whatever. Kill stuff. So what do we do here? Walk around, explore the world! Meet people, and kill them. Although, actually, I don't usually kill the people I meet. I usually just kill the random NPCs that are random enemies. NPCs I'm usually friendly to. I don't generally kill NPCs. Unless they try to kill me first. Alright, fine. We'll do this the smart way. Smart-ish, at least. Man, what the heck is with you? No, no matter. You're dead now. Because here I thought a dropping attack would work, but I've got dropping attacks suck in Dark Souls 3. At my own peril. What the heck was that? Okay, was that the thing that tried to kill me before? Oh, what the heck? Oh, come on! How was I supposed to see that coming? This area is not impressing me. At all. The wolves are fine, I can deal with that. I mean, they're relatively weak enemies, so whatever. But what the hell is shooting at me, and how am I supposed to know that was a thing? Where the hell are those arrows even coming from? Let's just run. Maybe if I'm lucky, I'll find a way of getting around quickly before the bloody arrows hit me. Okay, well that's a good bit of a start, I guess. Hey, Titanite Lizard! Something positive, finally! Oh, come on, get over here! Let me kill you! Oh, you bastard! You're supposed to die. Oh, well, you did die. Okay, fine. Point made. Ow! See, what level did they expect a character to be at before entering here? Because I feel like I expect you to have beaten the game, but at the same time, I'm getting a bunch of upgrade gear that I could get anytime. Like, literally anytime. Well, okay, anytime past, like, Fair and Keep. But still, this isn't that impressive. I don't really understand the idea here. Yeah, I get it. More large titanite shards. Woo. Give me something I actually care about. Like, some cool new weapon or something. Okay. I don't know what the hell was causing that. There was an item here. Why was there no item here? It was very much like there. Oh. Okay, am I dead? No, I'm not dead. I live. Except there's crabs under the ice. Oh, and you're just gonna be a butt about it. Oh, come on, that's not even a valid hitbox. All right. One can only hope these things don't respawn, but they probably will. Ow. Another one? Well, it's one down for what it's worth. But there's two of them. That's just perfect. And you just drop a large titanite shard, which, yeah, real helpful. And I'm aware of the giant enemy crabs already. That's nothing new. Hey, a bonfire! Alright, well, that seems like a good place to stop. Nope, they're trolling me. Alright, well, that's that, I guess. There's no illusory wall. All right, well, that's it for this episode. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed that more than I did, because this area here, I don't know. It's a thing. It exists. There's a lot of wolves. If you like wolves, come here. If you like being eaten by wolves, more so than actually liking them as pets, for instance, yeah, this is great for you.